God says this three remain: faith, hope, love. But the greatest of all is love. Before the year ends, let us be reminded once again of God's immeasurable love and favor upon His people through His Son, Jesus Christ. And today, we welcome you all to our SOP Christmas celebration. In Nazareth, Joseph the carpenter was introduced to Mary, a Jewish girl from the village. With the blessing of her father, Mary and Joseph are now betrothed, promised to each other just like a marriage. One day, God sent His angel to bring Mary the good news. The Lord's angel asked her to not fear, for she has been chosen. Mary will become pregnant with a baby boy, and the angel instructed her to name the child Jesus. He will be supreme, and He will be known as the Son of the Most High, and His kingdom will reign forever. With all her faith, Mary accepted her fate and wishes that everything God planned for her may come to pass.
Will one day rule the nations? Did you know?
To Bethlehem, a long way from Nazareth. It was then a long and difficult journey as Mary is about to give birth to her child. After finally reaching Bethlehem at night, they desperately search for a place to stay, but they were turned down. Joseph walked all over the town, knocking at the doors of houses, one after another. Losing hope, Joseph found an empty barn built for cows where they can settle. Finally, they rested.
No.
sees to it that the prophecy is made true. As Mary and Joseph are prophesied to bear the Holy Child, let all angels sing and let men kneel and praise for the Father's love. For mankind is never less, and so is his love to his mighty one. Behold, for the birth of the King is at hand, the Savior of humankind. In its humble beginning, hail the name of the mighty King. Let us worship him.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Come on, let's all stand up on our feet. Can we just give God all the glory and be clapping over our hands? Come on. He deserves more than that. Come on. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. He deserves all the glory. Praise God. Come on, let's just pray for a moment. If it's not hard for you, just lift up your hands towards heaven. Let's just thank the Lord. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you that, Lord, throughout this year 2022, you have been so good in our lives. Today, Father God, we celebrate you. We celebrate your love. We celebrate Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, God, for the opportunity to serve you and to worship you. God, we just want to adore you at this very hour. May you bless everyone in this place. Holy Spirit, we welcome you in this place today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. Come on, church. Let us come and adore the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Woo!
Oh, come, let us adore. He embraced.
Jesus today, but not only His birth, but His very own life, and even His death and His resurrection. The very reason why Jesus was born is because of you. Pwede mo sabihin katabi mo, because of you. Grabe na pag-ibig, tama ba? Grabe na gugma, kana bitang mabuhi para mamatay. Ah, grabe no? You know, such a wonderful privilege today that we can gather together and celebrate the birthday of Jesus. Amen? Woo! There's no greater place, there's no better place to celebrate Jesus than to be here in the body of Christ, in the temple, in the sanctuary, just giving God all the praises because He deserves. Praise God. So today, family, just continue to worship the Lord. Can't just worship Him. Hallelujah. Let's just choose to worship because He deserves. You are the one at the beginning, one with God. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. to just thank the Lord. Thank the Lord for what He has done for this year in your life. Thank the Lord for what He has done in your marriage, in your family, in your health, in your business, in your studies, in your career. God deserves our praises. Amen. God deserves all the glory. God deserves all the honor. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. God is not about us, Lord, but it's all about You, Jesus. Lord, everything that we have, Lord, comes from You. Everything who we are today, God, it's all because of You. So today, God, we bring You back all the glory, the honor, and thanksgiving. We celebrate You. We celebrate Jesus. We celebrate Your love in this place today. All for Your glory, God, in Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say, amen. God, give God the glory. Woo! Praise God. Before you take a seat, say hi, hello to the person beside you. Come and extend your greetings. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Welcome, welcome everyone. You may now be seated.
On that same night, not very far away, three shepherds were out in the night looking for their sheep on a hill. Suddenly, they were blinded by a bright light from the sky. When they opened their eyes, appeared before them is an angel and spoke to them the good news. It says, "Tonight, in a town in Bethlehem, a child was been born. His name is Jesus. He will be known as a Savior of the world. Go and let everyone know that Jesus, the King of the Jews, was born today." The angel let the shepherds go in peace and deliver the good news.
So hang on.
yourself a merry little Christmas now. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Thank you, Kuya. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Rain.
a hand to the Tagaytayan brothers and sisters. Thank you, Teacher Ava. Wow.
Thank you also to our pianist, Kuya Jay Banyas, yeah. All the way from Manila.
Yeah, kagagaling lang ng Spain, okay? Tumutugtog yan ng barko. Maraming salamat, Kuya Jay. Let's give them a hand one more time. Praise God, praise God.
We would like to greet everyone a Merry Christmas.
Yes,
Merry Christmas,
Christmas.
Everyone.
Yeah. Yes. One more time, say to the person beside you, Merry Christmas. Ooh. Come on, at your back, Merry Christmas. Extend
sabay
your
ngiti,
smile.
Sabay ngiti, sabay ngiti.
Yes,
a Merry,
yes.
Merry Christmas.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the Sanctuary of Praise International Church. Today is our celebration of our Christmas special. So we'd like to welcome everyone in this place today.
I think this is the first time that we do this Christmas special, right?
Yes, yes.
And we hope to do it every year. Tama po ba?
Yes.
It's a wonderful time to be celebrating Christ in this way, no? With your family and with your friends. Thank you so much. Mayroon ba tayong mga first timer dito? If this is your first time, we would like to welcome you to the Sanctuary of Praise. Thank you so much.
Yes.
For being with us, joining
Come
the celebration
on,
with us
today.
This
is your first time. Pwede bang tumayo?
Pwede ba makita natin yung kamay ng mga first time?
I think we have a friend from Australia.
Yeah.
All right.
Palakpakan natin
friend.
Sila. Palakpakan.
Pwede ba natin patayuin yung ating mga first timer? Wow. Sige, kaway-kaway na lang. Hello.
Welcome to SOP.
Welcome. Welcome. Of course, we'd like to welcome and recognize our SOP Bishop. Bishop Jen, my father, daddy, can you stand so that they will see you?
And
my beautiful mom is there with us today. And my family, you know, from General Santos City, where are they? Yeah, that's my brother from Jensen. Wow, such a beautiful day today. Is God good in your life? Amen. God has been so good. We'd like to welcome again in the family. We have Ma'am Tina all the way from Davao City. Palakpakan din natin si Ma'am Tina.
Yeah.
Yes,
our
thank
online
you.
Friends and
yes.
Family.
Yeah, online
thank you so
viewer
much for joining
natin,
us.
But we became an SOP family. Yes. Now we'd like to call all our kids in the house. Sige po, fam, can we extend our hands towards our kids right now and let us declare blessings to all of them?
Yeah.
Father, we thank you for the gift of children in the family, Lord. We thank you, God, for their lives, and we release
yes,
blessing upon them today. I pray, Father God, for good health every day. Wala pong magkakasakit sa kanila.
Amen.
Give them brighter future in the name of
thank
Jesus.
You.
Lord, that in their own generation, they will win souls and make disciples.
Yes,
they
Lord.
Will serve you for the rest of their lives. May you bless their parents, Father God,
Amen.
For molding them, Lord, in the Christian life, Father. Bless their family that they represent. And to those, God, who desires to have children, I speak, Father God, fertility in their womb. They will have their children in their own perfect time as well in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, for everything. We bless you and honor you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
At this time, since this is a Christmas is giving, so each child will receive one gift. So, thank you so much. Hindi po ipapabanggit ng ating mga donors, pero mga sponsors dito. Pero marami salamat. Pwede po natin palakpakan muna ang ating mga sponsors. Thank you very much. So, ushers, you may now...
Okay, distribute.
Give. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yay.
Yes. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. All right, at this time, I know that we are all excited to hear the Word of God. Are you all excited to hear the message of the Lord for this Christmas? Amen. It's such a wonderful season, wonderful time to celebrate Jesus. But this time, let us all hear the Word of God through our dear Pastora. Let's welcome Pastora Lay for the Word of God.
Praise God. Thank you, Pastor Franklin. Come on, let's just start with the Word of the Lord today. I'm going to make it short. This would be the first time that I have planned it, a very, very short message. So let's just bow down for a moment. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, God. Lord, this season is not complete, Lord, without hearing the Word of the Lord, because this is the main course of our service today. So God, I ask you, Holy Spirit, to just anoint us and speak to our hearts. We love you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say amen and amen. So, Merry Christmas once again. Kumusta po ang ating Pasko? Kumusta kagabi? No, kisa din mga wala gitulog? Or maybe some of you, you slept so very little hours, but Can you say congratulations to the person beside you? Congratulations that you are here. Yes, maybe some of your friends or your family, no, traveled from afar, no, or daghan kaig mong dapat gusto adtuan, but you chose to be here, no. Just like Ma'am Tina, naaram ta sa Davao pero no anye jo just to be here, no, in our service today. So thank you so much for being here. Maybe ang iba, no, ang saya-saya ng Pasko, pero ang iba siguro mas maraming luha kaysa tuwa. Meron ba dito na grabe kagabi, no, ang saya-saya ng kapitbahay nyo, pero ikaw yung taong umiiyak? No, but, oh, may nag-amen dito. Cheer up mo yung katabi mo, no? Cheer up. Still a Merry Christmas. I like that song, one of the familiar songs that we used to hear, no, Christmas song, yung sinasabi na, kahit na anong mangyari, si Jesus pa rin ang maghari. Right? Anong kadugtong yon? Kahit na anong pait, anong sakit, pero tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang Pasko. Amen! Kahit na umiyak yung katabi mo, tuloy pa rin ang Pasko. Kahit na marami kayong pinagdaanan ngayong week na ito, pero tuloy pa rin ang Pasko. Amen! Sabi yung katabi mo, tuloy pa rin. Tuloy pa rin ang Pasko. Now, let me share with you as quickly as I can the message of the Lord for us today, that it would like to teach us that Christmas should be more than just a celebration, but a revelation. Will you agree? That Christmas is not just about partying, eating food, exchanging of gifts, but actually, Christmas is a revelation. Everybody say revelation. So the title of the message of the Lord today is Christmas Revelation. What do you mean by revelation? It's just like a gift, right? Hindi mo malalaman kung ano ang laman pag hindi mo in-unwrap, right? The token or the gift inside will not be revealed if you don't unwrap it. So today, we will unwrap the message of Christmas so everyone of us could fully understand what is really the meaning of Christmas. And of course, our main verses, we have only one verse for today, and it's found the very most common verse in the Bible in John 3:16. Sige, everybody, yung mga nakaka-memorize, sabayan niyo po ako, ready, go? For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. So there are four points that I'd like to leave you today, fam. Number one point, Christmas revelation is a revelation of His faithfulness. Everybody say faithfulness. Yes, because it says in our main verse for today, for God so loved the world. Pwede mo bang i-remind yung katabi mo na love ka ni Lord? Sige, i-remind mo siya. Baka nakalimutan niya na mahal pala siya ng Panginoon. Alright? Minsan, ang dami-dami nating hinahanap na pag-ibig kanino man, pero ang totoo, there's only one love that can really satisfy the deepest need of our hearts, and that is God. And Christmas would remind us that God has been faithful. Sino pong naniniwala that God is faithful? Right? Siguro nagka-COVID ka, isa ka sa mga nagka-COVID ngayong taong ito na akala mo you cannot make it, pero look at you right now, you're beautiful, you're handsome. God has been faithful. Amen? Maybe some of you lubog na lubog sa utang, akala mo hindi ka makakabayad, but God has been faithful, nakabayad ka. Amen? Siguro ang iba, you came from a heartbreak for this year. Nagmahal ka, pero iniwan ka. Pero ang totoo, God is still faithful. Can we all say, God is faithful? Pag faithful si Lord sa buhay mo, pwede mo ba siyang palakpakan? Thank you, Jesus. God is faithful. We are reminded today that God is ever mindful of us. And He has a perfect timing. Maybe some of you, isa ka sa mga nag-board exam this year, nag-take ka ng bar exam at nakapasa ka, God has been faithful. Congratulations, amen? Or maybe some of you felt that you failed the exam. But hey, listen, God is still faithful. The faithfulness of the Lord cannot be measured by your successes. But the faithfulness of the Lord will be defined of how faithful He is. God is faithful, period. Amen? Hindi na magbabago yan. Well, number two, second point that we have today, Another Christmas revelation that we can understand about Christmas is a revelation of His generosity. According to John 3:16, the highlight of this point is that He gave His one and only Son. He gave His one and only Son. He gave His one and only Son. Nakuha ba natin yon? Sino po dito sa'yo na meron kang bagay na nag-iisa lang yon at ang hirap-hirap ibigay dahil alam mong wala kang ibang katulad ng ganon? Na kumbaga merong nagpaparinig sa'yo, eh sige, bigay mo na sa akin, parang bagay yan sa akin. Siguro sasagutin mo, uy, hingin mo na lang yung iba. Wag lang yan, nag-iisa lang to eh. But you know, the truth about Jesus, about God's generosity, He can give up everything for you. Grabe. What a love. So Christmas is about His being generous. Generous ang Panginoon. At dahil mapagbigay ang Panginoon, ikaw rin ay mapagbigay. Amen? Tingnan mo yung itsura ng katabi mo. Mapagbigay yan. Amen? Hindi yan laging nanghihingi at nanghihingi ng libre, pero yan ang nanglilibre at nagbibigay. Kay liwat siya ni Lord. Amen? Inim katapat, liwat ka ni Lord. Amen. Because God is a generous God. Christmas is not about receiving, but it's about giving. Can you hear amen? No? One of our life groups, I've read from their GC na they did a caroling, pero hindi sila yung humingi. Sila yung nagdala. Wow. Praise God. Good job. Good job. Let's keep doing that. Being generous to others. If others like something about you, then give it away. Right? Right? Can you hear amen? Because Christmas is giving. We're so glad. I'm going to want to give you a short news about our outreach in Sibawan. This was last Sunday. 100 of them receive what you have given. So palakpakan natin. Right? Alright? Congratulations. And thank you so much. Daghang salamat sa tanang naghatag og pagkaon, sa tanang mga bata na kadawat og regalo, tanang mga nanay, mga tatay na kadawat og grocery. Palakpakan natin si Lord. Wow! You know what? Iba sa atin sa ministry, siguro napansin nyo, last week sa ating year-end Thanksgiving, wala tay kaon na kanang bunggahan, yud na kaon, right? Even here in our Christmas celebration, because talagang sinadya natin ito dahil yung pera na kakainin ng sana natin, ibigay na lang natin sa iba. Can you hear amen? Amen. Because it's not about us. It's about others. And another good news that the other day, we have visited also one of the jails. Here, I will not mention because it's not allowed actually, not just to, for their privacy. Also, we have given groceries for them. Yung mga binigay nyo po last Sunday, talagang naipaabot natin ito lahat sa kanila. So, daghang kaayong salamat. You know, it was really great time when we visited them. I can really feel their, you know, their emptiness, their loneliness of being away from their families and loved ones. And it gave them so much comfort. Before we have given these items, the groceries to them, we have they have heard testimonies from our marshal, from our volunteers who visited with us, and they gave song, and Pastor Franklin also shared the gospel to them. They all received Jesus in their hearts, and that's really one thing. It's more than enough, right? And they have received these gifts, and we have found out that yung nagbigay po ng thank you message is nag-birthday pala that very day. So we acted right away. We bought cake for one of the inmates there. If you can observe, talagang sinadya ko pong giblur lang yung mukha para hindi makilala, no? But he's very thankful. Nilagay po namin sa cake niya from SOP family. So kasali po kayo doon. Alam nyo, yan lang pala yung wish niya na magkaroon siyang cake. He never thought that meron palang magbibigay ng cake sa araw niya. 5 years na siyang sa bilangguan at ngayon lang siya nagka-receive ng cake again. You know, iba talaga pag yung puso natin mapagbigay. Can you hear amen? Amen. Mapagbigay. Say to yourself, I am a generous giver. I am generous. Let us practice generosity, right? Not only to others, but even to the Lord by bringing back what is due to Him. Now let's go to the second last, and I'm about to end with the message of the Lord today. Another Christmas revelation that we can find from the Christmas itself is that a revelation of His intimacy. Everybody say intimacy. Again, from our main passage today, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish. You know, God doesn't want us to be far from Him, but God wants us to build a close relationship with Him. Can you hear amen? That we need to build a close relationship with the Lord. If you have not received yet Jesus in your heart, I encourage you, accept Jesus in your heart. To our online viewers today, find a Bible-believing church where you can grow in your spiritual life. We need Jesus. Can we all say, I need Jesus? Tag somebody, you need the Lord. We all need the Lord. And God wants us to be intimately close to Him. Iba kasi yung kilala mo, pero wala kang relasyon. Halimbawa, kilala mo, sinong presidente natin? Kilala mo yung presidente natin na si BBM, pero wala kang relasyon sa kanya. Kung minsan ganun din yung spiritual life natin, kilala mo si Lord, pero wala kang relasyon sa kanya. Today, let this be a reminder that Christmas is having a relationship with the Lord, because a revelation of His intimacy must be always be built in our lives. Next slide, I have put it there. The cost of the gift given is the worth of the person receiving. Can you see how special you are? Because you are so special, God sent His one and only Son because of you. Pwede ba sabihin katabi mo, you are so special. Mahalaga ka. Kaya nga dahil sa, because of how special you are, God sent Jesus in our lives. And lastly, I'm about to end. Wow. Number 4. Christmas is a revelation of reconciliation. It says there for you to have an eternal life. Because supposedly, we will be fall to that fire, not of hell, but because of God's love, He reconciled us to His to be back into relationship with Him. And this is a sacrifice for you and me to have a relationship with Him, because God wants us to be reconciled with Him. Now, and speaking of reconciliation, kasali na rin dito, baka meron kayo dito mga kagalit, naaba kayo mga kaaway, karon na week. I hope and pray na bago matapos yung taong ito, tama na, sabi yung katabi mo, tama na! At magpatawad ka na. Amen. Christmas is a revelation of reconciliation. Christmas is forgiving. Right? Magpatawad tayong mga asawa. Basig na adri nag-away. Tama na. Amen. Wala kang ibang mamahalin kundi siya lang. Amen. We need to be reconciled with your brothers. Baka meron kang kapamilya dito. No, nakaaway mo, kapatid mo. We need to be reconciled. And this is our point for today, that Christmas is not just about us, but it's really about the Lord. So as I end with the word of the Lord today, I have placed there in my slide that God didn't save you from something. He saved you for something. Today, fam, let us all remember that God saved you for a purpose, and that is to win souls and make disciples. Let's keep winning for the Lord. Let's continue to expand the kingdom and the ministry of the Lord towards others who needs Jesus. Are we blessed that we have Jesus in our lives? If you are blessed, come on, we want you to stand up on your feet as we close the word of the Lord today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Right now, maybe if you have your family here, come on, just stand beside your family. Just thank the Lord together as a family. Praise God. Praise God. As we end, fam, this is the very last Sunday of the year 2022. And let us grab this opportunity to just bring back all the glory, all the honor to the Lord. Amen. Amen. Can we just bow down our heads? Come on, just worship. Just thank the Lord. I cannot do this for you. Just say, thank you, Jesus. What are the things that you're thanking the Lord? Just thank Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. If hindi mahirap sa'yo, pwede ba natin itaas ang ating kamay sa Panginoon? All my life thank the Lord together. Can say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I thank you for this year. I thank you for your faithfulness. I thank you for your generosity. Thank you for everything that you have done in my life. Today, Lord, I choose you. I choose you, God. I choose to have a relationship with you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for the gift of reconciliation, for the gift of forgiveness, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God, may you bless every heart in this place today and all our online worshipers, God. May they receive their portion as well. We bring you back all the glory, the honor, and thanksgiving. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, one more time. Palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. Before you sit down, find a family. Find a family. Come, just hug your family. Say, I love you. I care for you. I celebrate Jesus with you. Wow. Thank you so much, fam. We love you. We love you. To God be all the glory, and you may be seated.
Baby Jesus, the three wise men from the east came to Jerusalem looking for the child who is said to be the King of the Jews, for they have seen his star when it rose. The three went on their way and followed the star until it stopped over the place where the child was. The three wise men came forward and saw the baby Jesus lying on a barn with his mother. In amazement, they bowed down and worshipped him in reverence. Before them, they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, valuable gifts only given to the kings.
Born King to see, ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Amen. Isang malakas sa palakpak for the Lord. Come on! I said malakas sa palakpak para kay Lord. Come on! Yeah! Merry Christmas once again to everyone. And it is indeed a very wonderful time to celebrate Jesus. What a wonderful day to celebrate God. Amen. It is indeed about the love of the Lord that we are here today. And isa sa mga na-learn ako sa message today is about the revelation of this Christmas. It's not just about celebration. It's not just about having this party, having new gifts, having a reunion of the family. Well, mga secondary na lang na, but daghan dito katong apat ka revelations ginina. But one thing that struck me is about the revelation of generosity. Amen? When Jesus was born in a manger, that is a gesture of generosity of our God. And let's all be reminded and let us all ponder on that message of God, that this celebration of Christmas, unang-una, it talks about generosity of our God. When God sent His one and only Son, He gave His one and only Son. That's why, ngayon na ay mga giving, it's not about asking, but it's always about giving. Because Christmas revelation, it's one is about being generous, being kanang giver. Because God Himself manifested that character that He is a giver. And that's why this afternoon, as we are preparing our tithes and offering envelope, no, please prepare it now as we will be giving it back to the Lord. We are declaring, Lord, kining mga resources nga among nadawat, kining mga income, kining mga blessings, Lord God, wala ra gyud ni. Dili namo kaya kang i-outgive, bisan pag ihatag nimo ang tanan. Bisan pag ihatag nimo ang 1 month nimong salary, ang 1 year nimong salary, bisan ihatag nimo ang tanan kay Lord, di gyud ka kabayad sa pagkamaayo sa Ginoo sa atong kinabuhi. Amen. Bisan pagbiyen ka, Lord, I'm giving everything to you. You cannot really outgive God because God is a generous God. Bisag muhatag kag gamay, pero dublihon man nagbalik ni Lord si Muha. Bisag muhatag kag 20, pero dublihon man nagbalik ni Lord si Muha. So unsay imuhang ikabalos sa Ginoo? It's just a heart. It's just your faithfulness to the resources, to every blessing that we receive from the Lord. Amen? God has blessed us. Sabi nga ng Bible, God will make you rich. God will enrich us in so many ways so that it will result to our generosity and to our thanksgiving. God will always bless us because promise man ni Lord that God will bless the works of your hands. If you are faithful with what God has entrusted you, I believe that God will entrust you even more. Amen? God will entrust you with even bigger kung faithful ka sa mga ginagmay. Muna mga ginagmay ganin mong ma-receive diha kay Lord, ayaw yun pag-alanganin nga muhatag, mubalik diha sa Lord o say, para kay Lord. Pila lagi pa ngayon ni Lord, 10%. Anyway, that's 10%. Kuan lang na siya, a minimum. Na you can give even 20%, 30%, 100%. But again, it is about your heart. It's not about the amount. It's not about how big you give to the Lord, but it is about how you really give to the Lord. Amen? Let's all stand. Let's all stand as we are preparing our tithes and offering into the Lord. Amen. And let's pray muna for the words for this offering. Father in heaven, we honor you for this wonderful day. Lord, for this entire year, 2022, Lord God, you have been so faithful. You have been so good to us, oh God. Thank you for every blessing that we receive. Thank you for everything, Lord God, that we receive. Every day, Lord God, gipakaon minimo Ginoo. Every day, Lord God, imo mong giatiman. Every day, Lord, wag minimo gipasagdan, Lord God. And thank you. We have come this far, Lord God, this year, 2022. Ready, Lord God, to face the new year, 2023, Lord God. Full of expectation, Lord God, for the new things, Lord God, imong ihatag ka namong tanan, Lord. And Father, we honor you, Lord God, with this little amount imong ibalik ka na kanimo, Lord God. But Lord, this is our faithfulness nga na kanimo, Lord. Thank you for every resources Ginoo nga imong gi-entrust ka namo. And Lord God, we want to be faithful. We want to be a good stewards, Lord God, sa tanang blessings nga imong gi-entrust ka namo, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. I pray for every hand, Lord God, nga mubalik diha kanimo, Lord God, tanang nga maghulog karon sa ilahang mga offering, Lord God, tithes, Lord, magbalik kanimo. I pray for your reward of blessing, Lord God, be upon them in the name of Jesus. We give you glory, we honor you in Jesus. Jesus' name, amen and amen. Can we declare that? Do we have declarations? Come on. Come on, itasa ito mga envelope. And declare today, as we bring these tithes and my offering and gifts unto the Lord, we believe by faith for the Lord's mercy and grace, happy and healthy family, needs provided, increase in all things, jobs or better jobs with higher salary, increasing production in the businesses, gifts and surprises, finding money, bills paid off, debts demolished, presents received, to win souls, SOP lot and building, to win souls and make disciples that makes disciples. Come on, let's give our offering into the Lord. Let's keep standing as we declare our victory songs today before we will go home. Thank you so much, by the way. Thank you so much for joining with us today sa ating Christmas special. Sa mga first-timer, sa mga second-timer, thank you. We hope to see you. By the way, our announcement this Sunday, this is our New Year's celebration, okay? So it's Sunday, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Doon po tayo sa Boylins, no? So 3 o'clock in the afternoon, we hope to see you with your friends and with your family. And let's all together, sugato na to ang bagong tuig, uban ang pagdaig niya sa Ginoo. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Come on, let's give God a mighty clap of praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, everyone, for coming today. Come on, let's give God the glory. Let's end this service by singing a victory song.